Thank you, Madam Chair. Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
And I must say that I have to give a shout out to someone who's on your staff who would have been sitting here were she not stolen by you, Senator, former Senator Hassel Thompson. So welcome, Senator. Sorry you're not here, but glad you're there.
Thank you,
forgive you. But let me just try to go through a couple of the issues that I want to raise with you before my time runs out, because you don't have a time limit, but I do. So first of all, you know that my district, I don't know if you do know my district.
I do.
You do. And we're the epicenter of gentrification in a very large sense. So the issue of housing, affordable housing, is severe. And we also have, along with that, an issue of supportive affordable housing. So my questions are related to the supportive housing area that you plan in particular. Can you give us an idea of how many units you intend to bring on currently and in the next year or so of supportive housing in New York City in particular? And in the city, but certainly in areas like mine, like I represent.
Sure. So the governor laid out last January a commitment of 6,000 units of supportive housing over the next 5 years. We are thrilled to say that we have awarded funds for the first 1,200, so the first year's commitment against that 6,000, making us sort of on time and on target for that. And we have behind that a robust pipeline of supportive housing units that we will continue over the course of the next years to meet that 6,000 unit goal. In terms of the split, we would suspect that our development tracks the demand. The majority of the demand is in New York City, although there certainly is supportive housing need upstate as well. So we would expect the majority of the 1,200 each year to be in New York City, but you know, there's a great need upstate too, and we have a lot of wonderful nonprofit and for-profit partners who develop that housing across the state.
And will the majority of that be done by the not-for-profit community in particular?
Traditionally, the not-for-profit community has been sort of the leader in developing supportive housing. We also have some partners who are for-profits who are very strong, who sometimes develop on their own. Oftentimes, they're partnering with nonprofits who may prefer to just provide services and don't necessarily want to own and operate real estate. So it's a mix, but I think you'll find that the majority of the, historically, the majority of the development of supportive housing has been nonprofit-driven.
I'm glad to hear that, and hopefully that will continue. with regard to two other issues that I want to raise with you, I don't know if you're familiar with the Northwell report, which is really related to health care, a health care delivery system, and improving that in North Brooklyn. But part of that, their report and their recommendations have to do with housing as well. And so I've asked the former, the OMH commissioner the same question, and I'm asking you to what extent you're planning to coordinate your efforts and your plans with OMH, OPD, health, to make sure that their plan is complementary to whatever you're planning, especially as it relates to supportive housing, because that's apparently mostly what they will be doing.
I did read the Northwell report, although I only actually read the sections that related to housing, not the sections that related to health, and it was a very long, extensive report. I'm happy to say we are working very closely on an interagency task force around housing related to the Northwell report and the hospital transformation in Central Brooklyn. So we're very well coordinated, and where there's housing opportunities, we will jump right into those and provide the appropriate mix and type of housing that's suitable depending on the different locations.
So I want to take this opportunity to invite you to my district so that you can see some of the projects that you've done in prior years and how it works. And of course, the not-for-profit housing communities have an extremely difficult problem trying to coordinate different agencies' requirements and timelines and regulations and et cetera. So that's going to be very, very important when it comes to utilizing your agency as a lead agency in helping us to develop that housing. So hopefully that can happen. Just one last question on NYCHA. Now, the last time that we did $100 million for NYCHA that the state allocated, I consider that having been sprinkled like confetti. So I want to hear from you what of that $100 million was used for structural improvements, because I represent, for instance, one of the communities that I represent is Red Hook. And the damage from the floods were extensive, but also just generally speaking, projects in my district are in great disrepair, as other senators have pointed out. And so I'm just curious about, one, what happened to the $100 million, where it went, what did it do to help improve the situation, the structural situations, and what are your plans for the next $100 million as it relates to addressing the needs structurally and not cosmetically only?
I can take a piece of that, and Jamie can fill in what I miss. On the first 100, $50 million that has gone to DASNY of the first 100 is four projects that are underway, and the anticipation is that those projects will be completed within the year. I don't have a list with me of what those actual projects are, but we would be happy to get that information.
I would like to see
you.
Them. I would like that.
In terms of the second 100, excuse me, there's no predetermined notion yet as to what that funding would go towards. I think that's still open to conversation, and to the extent that it's important to that it be for structural purposes in your community, I think we'd be happy to have that conversation.
Well, I've spent so much time with the NYCHA administration, and they were as shocked as I was to see that we were not putting the major part of that funding on absolutely structural repair needs. And so I'm hopeful that this will be very different as we move forward. You talk about preserving 50,000 units. Obviously, NYCHA is the largest stock of absolutely affordable housing. So we really need to and have to pay special attention to it. So I thank you for that. And with that, I return my time.
Thank you, Senator.